Today I thought you might like a look at this 1972 Mercury Cougar XR7 Convertible. And this is a really nicely kept original, so I thought we'd take a look at it here. You can see in 72 they had the quad headlamps up front and a really nice looking grille here in the center. Got a Mercury script badge right on the front edge of the hood, and it's painted in a sort of gold metallic. If I can catch some of that sunlight there, you can probably see the metallic in the paint, hopefully. And overall, I mean, it's just a really nice straight car, as you can see. It's white wall tires. It's got a little Cougar badge here on the fenders. Glass looks good. Nice body color mirrors. The convertible top is still in really nice shape as well. And these have those inset door handles, so they're flush mounted. It's pretty cool. And nice original interior in here as well. Here, we'll take a closer look. You can see it still has the original door panels. Nice set of tall back bucket seats. It still has the factory three-spoke wheel with a Cougar right there in the center. And nice set of gauges on here too. Got the 6,000 RPM tach on the left, 120 mile per hour speedometer to the right. And you have some auxiliary gauges right here in the center. And you got your heat and AC controls there. And it is an automatic on the console. Most likely a C6 automatic in this case. I mean, just really nice shape overall. I see just one crack over there on the passenger side, but other than that, the dashboard looks nice and smooth. I mean, just a nice original Survivor. Here, we'll continue on out back. I mean, a really solid car, as you can see. There's no rust anywhere that I can see. Nice big chrome bumper out back, and pretty good sized trunk on these cars. And I honestly don't know if that's the original paint. I mean, there's a chance that it's been resprayed at some point, but other than that, it really hasn't been messed with. And as we walk down the side here, you can see, I mean, it's not all wavy or anything. It's a nice straight car. Here, let's go ahead and pop open the hood and see what's going on under there. All right, as you can see, it's looking really nice under the hood here as well. It looks like it's even wearing its factory paint still. This is actually powered by a 351 Cleveland two barrel, as you can see there on the air cleaner. But looking very original under here. It does still have the factory AC compressor up top, but it looks like it's not hooked up at the moment. I can see they don't have a belt on it, and they've had some kind of problem here. But at least it's all nice and factory original under here. And it wouldn't be too hard to track down another AC compressor, I'm sure. But overall, very clean and just hasn't been messed with at all. And honestly, the 351 Cleveland is one of my favorite Ford engines that they ever put out. I think I'd probably swap on an intake and a four barrel, just because I'm not a huge fan of two barrel carbs. But overall, looking pretty good under there. Very nice. Okay, let's go ahead and check out the information on it. Once again, it's a 1972 Mercury Cougar XR7. 88,000 original miles. And they say it runs good. But I mean, just a car that you don't see all the time. And definitely well preserved. Pretty sharp looking example. Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you found that one interesting. I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have, and I'll see you later. Bye.